In this video, we explore how to find and fix broken links in D2L Brightspace. As a quick preview, we'll begin with what our students need, and then we'll delve into how to find broken links, how to fix those links or embeds, and do manual reviews for bad links that may not emerge using the broken links tool that is built into D2L Brightspace. Let's begin with what students need. Ideally, as we begin our classes, our students will have links that work like a charm. Of course, that isn't always the case, hence this video. We also try to include source information, and this is important for students so that they can locate the original sources in the event that a link breaks, and it's also important for citation in their papers or projects in the event that you're asking them to cite sources from your class. Finally, some students actually need PDFs, and we have a separate video that you can watch on how to add PDFs to your classroom. So let's begin by looking at how we use this broken links tool, which is built right in to D2L. First thing you're going to want to do is navigate to the course admin tool. At Pima Community College, we locate it underneath the course resources tab. Again, you'll go to your course, then click on the course resources tab, then click on course admin. The broken links tool is the one you're going to want to look for. There are a bunch of choices again when you click on course admin. There may be as many as 30. Again, look around for the one that says broken links and click on it. Then the first thing you'll do is set the date range, and you're going to start with the earliest possible edits in the course, moving up to today to make sure you capture any possible errors in broken links from any possible date. Then you're going to review those links. You can see an example that I've included in this slide that's blurred out, but it includes potentially a whole lot of broken links. You may need to click on the Load More button to see the full scope of those broken links. Then you're going to identify what actually needs to be fixed. What I mean by that is that you may have some hidden modules in your course with links that don't technically need to be fixed. The ones that matter are the ones that students are actually clicking on. And you can tell that through this preview, which provides in its table format a number of clicks. You can tell what's being used simply by looking at the number of clicks. So on the left side, again, we first see a checkbox. Next, we see the linked from category, which shows where in your course it's located. That's the URL that you can copy and paste later into your browser, and then see the original link that's broken and fix it. This third column is the number of clicks, and the fourth column is the target URL. That is the broken URL, the one that you need to find the original link for and replace it within D2L. So again, the tool, which is called the Broken Links tool currently, does not enable you to edit those links within the tool. So we're not encouraging you to delete any of these links, but rather to fix them. You do have the option, as we noted from that first item checkbox, to check everything in the list and simply delete those links. But we would encourage you instead to go to the site, the original URL for each of those broken links within your course, and replace the external link. And we're going to walk through that process now. So again, you'll be visiting the linked from item, which is this column that is on the left. You'll be copying and pasting this URL into your browser. Simply open a new tab and paste it into that address bar, and then visit that specific course file. Once you're inside the course file, you'll be clicking on Edit HTML by finding the downward-facing chevron or context menu, clicking on that, then selecting Edit HTML. When you click on the Edit HTML button, it'll go into the text editor mode of the tool, and you'll be able to select that hyperlinked text and then click on that little link button in the icon. You'll see it here. It looks like a chain link. When you click on that, the first URL is the link in this context that you would be replacing with the updated link. I would leave the title exactly as it is. I would leave the target to open up in a new window, which basically means that when students click on it, it will open in a new tab in their browser. So again, you'll click on that item, you'll delete it, and you'll paste in the new URL. In order to find that updated URL, you'll need to go to the Pima Community College library. Once you're inside the library and you've found the resource that you're looking for, click on the permalink URL once it appears at the top of your page. If, for example, you're looking at the EBSCO tool, which is what I'm looking at now, you'll copy this, and then you're going to be pasting this back into your D2L course to replace the broken URL. If you want to learn how to find URLs in the first place, please take a look at our YouTube channel, which also includes videos on how to find numerous URLs for books, for articles, or for videos. Now, an advanced piece that we should take a look at here is how do we fix broken embeds? And this may be relevant to some of you. So first off, if a link is embedded within your course, like a video, you'll find the page initially within the content section, and you'll go straight into the source code editor, which is a little bit different from that initial text editor, which is called the HTML editor. You're looking at the actual code to do this advanced task. And you'll be doing something called replacing the iframe. So let's take a look at what that entails. First, you'll be editing the HTML, just like we did before. Clicking on that drop-down context chevron icon, choosing Edit HTML. Then on the next screen, you'll see kind of a preview again of what the text editor looks like. We're going to the lower right corner. You'll see this sort of less than, forward slash, greater than symbol. That is the source code editor that we're going to be opening. So you'll click on that. Once you're inside, you will be scrolling through the HTML code, and you'll be looking for something that says iframe relating to whatever the specific link was. Maybe it's a YouTube link that was broken. In this context, you can see a sample YouTube iframe that is embedded within a page, and sometimes it has to be replaced or deleted. So you'll go in and you'll find that specific iframe, which begins with the less than iframe and ends with the greater than forward slash iframe greater than. You'll be replacing that iframe with the new iframe that you find from YouTube, if there is a video that you can replace it with, for example, or from whatever other source you're pulling an iframe from. If your iframe just does not work, and what I mean by that is if it's not allowing the video to be resized on the page of your cell phone or tablet, then you can actually create a new iframe. There's a website called iframely.com, and you can simply visit that site and create a new embed code so that your video or whatever you're putting into the class will resize for whatever type of screen is being used. Finally, we would recommend manually reviewing your course for bad links, because everything doesn't always appear within your fix broken links tool in D2L. For example, here's a series of videos that I've included in my poetry writing classes that are from the Pima Community College Library. They are not necessarily going to look like they're broken. This first example is a beautiful Maya Angelou documentary from PBS. The second image is a documentary that I love that unfortunately is not available within Canopy, but you don't know it unless you click on it. So again, I would recommend clicking on any links that you're using within your course to make sure that they do indeed open up, because sometimes just because it's visible, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to be clickable. Finally, we'd recommend asking your students to report broken links to you so that you can repair those as soon as they emerge. That's the heart of it. Other topics that may be of interest to you after watching this video might be, how do we add ebooks, articles, or videos into D2L Brightspace from the library? How do we add PDFs into D2L Brightspace and other online resources for teaching? We have videos and content relating to all of these. So to learn more about resources and strategies for online teaching, we would encourage you to first visit our Pima Online YouTube channel, but then also visit our Pima Online faculty guide. The website is linked inside this video's description, and that's the heart of it.